As Sylvester Stallone begins his reign as the Tulsa King, EW looks back at the action icon's 10 most memorable movie roles, from cryocops to prizefighters. Sylvester Stallone, the artist colloquially known as Sly, is the only American actor to have a number one box office hit in each of the last six decades. A three-time Academy Award nominee, the actor, writer, director, and producer wrote his own ticket to the big time with 1970's Best Picture Oscar winner, Rocky, and quickly proved he was more than just a pair of bulging biceps. Before we dive into the main content, I want to talk to you about something important. If you find value in what you see today, I'd really appreciate your support. Here's how you can help. First, if you're enjoying the video, don't forget to hit that like button. It lets me know you're enjoying the content and helps others discover it as well. If you think this video can be helpful or entertaining for your friends or family, please consider sharing it. Sharing is caring, after all. If you're new here, or you haven't already, why not join our Disc Diggers family? Hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss an update from us. We post two videos every week. By liking, sharing, and subscribing, you're supporting the channel, and it motivates us to create more content you love. But remember, it's not just about us, it's about building a community of movie enthusiasts. Number 10. Freddie Heflin played in Copland, released in 1997. In this gritty neo-noir helmed by Logan director James Mangold, Stallone covered his trademark muscles and gained 40 pounds to portray Freddie Heflin, the lame duck sheriff of a New Jersey town inhabited by corrupt NYPD cops. After years of turning a blind eye to the duplicity around him, he chooses to take a stand and investigate the men he once idolized. The actor anchors Copland's stellar ensemble, which features Robert De Niro, Harvey Keitel, Annabelle Ashora, and the late Ray Liotta, and delivers one of the most understated, affecting performances of his career. Number 9. Johnny Kovac played in FIST, released in 1978. As Johnny Kovac, Stallone plays a 1930s Jimmy Hoffa-esque figure who rises from the working class of Cleveland to become a national union leader. After he unfairly loses his job, Kovac joins the Federation of Interstate Truckers, FIST, and makes a series of moral compromises on his road from exploited loading dock worker to powerful labor president. FIST was Sly's follow-up to his Oscar-nominated turn in Rocky, and while it didn't set the box office on fire, he received strong reviews for the Norman Jewison, Moonstruck, directed, Joe Esterhaas, Basic Instinct, penned film. Stallone would spend the next decade plus in oiled-up action poses, but this historical drama is a peek at the career path that could have been. Number 8. Barney Ross played in The Expendables, released in 2010. In The Expendables, Stallone returns to the director's chair to bring together some of the biggest stars of the action genre for a Dirty Dozen-style team-up. Their mission: take down the dictator of a fictional South American country while kicking as many butts and taking as many names as humanly possible. Sly reunites with his Rocky IV co-star, Dolph Lundgren, alongside a dream team of cinematic warriors such as Jason Statham, Mickey Rourke, Terry Crews, Jet Li, Randy Couture, Steve Austin, Bruce Willis, and Arnold Schwarzenegger. The 2010s hit was a return to box office success for the star, and showed that 30 years after his action debut, he still got it. Number 7. Deke DeSilva played in movie Nighthawks, released in 1981. Stallone's first lead action thriller role finds him partnered up with a post-The Empire Strikes Back Billy Dee Williams as they chase international terrorist Wolfgar, Rutger Hauer, through the streets of New York. Sly Sergeant Deke DeSilva is introduced in drag in one of the film's most memorable scenes, when he goes undercover to entrap a couple of muggers. Featuring several exciting cat-and-mouse chase sequences, Nighthawk's gritty aesthetic is a bridge between Stallone's more grounded earlier work and his later transformation into an untouchable cinematic warrior. Number 6. Gabe Walker played in Cliffhanger, released in 1993. National Park Service Ranger Gabe Walker is haunted by his failure to save his best friends, Michael Rooker, girlfriend, Michelle Joyner, after her harness breaks during a climb in the Colorado Rockies. 8 months later, he receives a fake distress call from a group of thieves, led by a scenery-chewing John Lithgow, and is forced to help them recover $100 million from a crashed U.S. Treasury cargo jet, or die trying. The star told EW in 1993 he had to overcome his own acrophobia to complete the death-defying, vertigo-inducing stunts. The gamble paid off, as the Rennie Harlan-directed cliffhanger was the beginning of a box office comeback for the leading man after a string of disappointments. In his review of the film, EW critic Owen Gleiberman wrote, "Sly has a wonderfully expressive face. It's exhilarating to behold the speed and sheer balletic confidence with which Stallone swings his overly muscled body around." Number 5. Lincoln Hawk played an over-the-top, released in 1987. This appropriately titled arm wrestling drama, scored by, of all people, disco legend Giorgio Moroder, may have been pinned by audiences at the time of its release, but it has gone on to become a cult classic in the years since. Stallone plays Lincoln Hawk, a truck driver who enters the World Arm Wrestling Championship in Las Vegas to win the cash needed to start his own trucking company, and win back his estranged son, Michael, David Mendenhall. As he journeys cross-country to the competition, Hawk also contends with his father-in-law, Robert Loggia, who seeks to drive a wedge between the pair and gain custody of Michael. Billed as a sports spectacle, Over the Top is actually a heartwarming family drama about a father reconnecting with his son, and features one of Stallone's most touching performances. Number 4. Marion Cabretti played in Cobra, released in 1986. Lieutenant Marion Cabretti is an LAPD cop who doesn't play by the rules. Crime is the disease and he's the cure, the type of rogue toothpick-chewing, beer-chugging policeman who gets results, firing off one-liners as easily as he does bullets. Sound familiar? While, yes, this could be the plot of any high-octane extravaganza from the 80s and 90s, the sheer lunacy of this script makes this one of the most enjoyable entries in Stallone's action hero career. A social Darwinist cult seeds chaos throughout Los Angeles to separate the weak from the strong. When model Ingrid Knudsen, Bridget Nielsen, witnesses their leader, the serial killer, the night slasher, Brian Earl Thompson, commit murder, Cabretti is tasked with keeping her safe. The screenplay for Cobra, written by Stallone, is based on ideas the star originally had for Beverly Hills Cop, before exiting that film over creative differences. While the script didn't lead to a second Best Original Screenplay Oscar nom, the mix of slasher and action movie elements has made it a cult classic of the genre. Number 3. John Spartan played in Demolition Man, released in 1993. The year is 1996. Los Angeles is a dystopian hellscape terrorized by the nefarious supervillain Simon Phoenix, Wesley Snipes. When LAPD Sergeant John Spartan, Stallone, botches an operation to rescue hostages from Phoenix's clutches, both men are sentenced to suspended animation and subliminal rehabilitation in California's cryopenitentiary. Awakened in 2032, the 21st century's most dangerous cop and most ruthless criminal will face off once again to determine the future of the utopian megacity of San Angeles. The 1993 sci-fi hit allowed Stallone to show off not only his action movie chops, but his comedic ones as well. As former EW critic Owen Gleiberman wrote, "He's a winning comedian in this movie, rolling his eyes at a world that no longer places any value on testosterone." With a charming supporting performance by a then-unknown Sandra Bullock as his wide-eyed sidekick, Lieutenant Lenina Huxley, Demolition Man is a must-watch for fans of Stallone's action movie oeuvre. Number 2. John Rambo played in First Blood released in 1982. Spanning 37 years, 5 films, video games, comic books, and even a 1986 animated series, Rambo, The Force of Freedom, John Rambo is not only one of Stallone's most famous roles, but one of the most famous action heroes of all time. Before Rambo morphed into a human Terminator in later installments, however, he started out as a Vietnam veteran struggling with PTSD, when the Green Beret is tormented by a corrupt police force in the Pacific Northwest, It triggers a flashback to his time as a POW, and a violent confrontation in the mountains ensues. Sly's depiction of the one-man army is an explosive mix of his trademark physicality and a slowly escalating rage at a country that turned him into a killer, and then turned its back on him. Number 1. Rocky Balboa, played in Rocky Balboa, released in 1976. Is there a more iconic Sylvester Stallone character than Rocky Balboa? While the popularity of Rambo certainly gives the Italian stallion a run for his money, the underdog from Philly is the role that catapulted him onto the A-list. One of EW's 25 best inspirational movies, this working-class fable of a small-time boxer who gets a shot at the big time brought him multiple Academy Award nominations, and a win for Best Picture, and launched not one, but two franchises. The title fight with heavyweight champ Apollo Creed, Carl Weathers, remains the most thrilling, edge-of-your-seat sequence in his filmography. Add in the iconic run up the steps of the Philadelphia Museum of Art, the most famous training montage in film history, and his classic "Yo, Adrian" catchphrase, and it's easy to see why Rocky knocks out the competition. No matter how many cliffs he hangs from or villainous goons he violently dispatches, Stallone will always be Rocky Balboa in the minds of moviegoers. His contributions to the sport through the Rocky franchise even landed him a spot in the International Boxing Hall of Fame. If you enjoyed this content and found it informative, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and hit that subscribe button for more exciting updates. Thanks for watching. Until next time, this is your host from Disc Diggers, signing off. Stay connected.